Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you how to use the Ebit Universal Test Fixture. It can test Ebit E9 series, E10 series, and E12 series miners. Let's first understand the materials and tools that will be used when testing the hash board. This is the Ebit Universal Test Fixture, which is mainly composed of a cable and a control board. The cable is mainly used to connect the hash board and the fixture. For ease of use, we can lengthen the cable. Then this is the main control board of the fixture. Also, we need to use a voltage-regulated PSU to power the hash board. In addition, we also need to use a DC 12 volts output PSU to power the main board of the tester. Ebit E12 hash board. We will use it for demonstration today. In addition to the above materials, we also need a network cable, which is mainly used to connect the main control board and the router. Okay, let's start to demonstrate the connection and setup of the tester. Step 1. We first connect the DC 12 volts power supply to the 6-pin interface of the board. And then power on the PSU. Step 2. Connect one end of the network cable to the main board, and the other end to the computer. This step is mainly for the test software can find the IP of the board. When the red light here goes out, and the green light flashes, it means that the ASIC firmware has been loaded. Step 3. Install the drivers. Open the Ebit copy folder. Then open the driver folder. And install the two drivers of the test software respectively. Double-click the first program to start the installation. Click Close when finished. Then proceed to install the second program as we demonstrated. Alright, both drivers are installed. Step 4. Find the IP of the control board. Open the Ebit Miner Mini program. Then click on LAN Management to start looking for IP. Look, the IP has been displayed here. Because the later steps need to use this IP, here we reserve it. Step 5. Install the test software. Open the Secure CRT folder. Then click the green icon. Enter the number 1 in the pop-up window and press the Enter key. Okay, close the pop-up window. When this icon appears on the computer desktop, it means that the test software has been installed. Next, we need to connect this end of the cable to the router. Look, this is the connection state. And the Wi-Fi address connected to the computer must be the same as the router connected just now. That is, the network segment of the computer and the control board must be the same. Use the cable to connect the test fixture and the hash board. Turn on the voltage-regulated PSU. And set its output voltage to 12 volts. The current can be automatically adjusted. Then connect the clips to the positive and negative poles of the hash board. And turn on the switch here, so that it can be powered normally. Now I will start to demonstrate the test steps for you. Open the test software, and set it up. Close the pop-up window, and click the icon here. Because the test fixture we use today has been set up, we directly choose this IP. Press the right mouse button and view properties. Set the IP of the hostname in SSH2 to be consistent with the IP of the control board. Attention, when using the test software for the first time, the two IPs may be different. We need to enter the found IP of the control board here. And finally click Confirm. Double-click the IP address here. When this interface appears, it means that the network connection is normal. Then you can choose the hash board model to be tested here. We choose the Ebit E12 model today, and finally click here to start the test. These contents indicate that the test software has been loaded. Then select the test mode from here. For example, we select the button 3 here. The test will start. Shown here are the test results. Well, the above is the tutorial of using the Ebit Universal Test Fixture. See you in the next video.